This is the day that the Lord hath made. Yes. How many of us have already started rejoicing? You don't have to wait until you get to the house, because the word says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving.
Yes, Lord.
And the way you enter into his gates with thanksgiving is by having thanksgiving before you get to the gate.
Yes.
So we are truly grateful to the Most High God for another opportunity to come into his house, gathering his name to worship him.
Oh, yes.
For those of you who are joining us here in the sanctuary, we thank God for you, as well as for those who are joining us online. To God be the glory for the things that he has done.
Yes.
And we've come here for the same purpose that we've been coming here.
Amen.
And that is to praise and worship the Most High God.
Oh, yes.
I know I may be standing in front of the camera today, but I'm not the one that we're here for.
All right.
And I pray that I'm not the one you came to see.
All right.
But the Lord is the one
who
woke you up this morning and started you on your way and gave you the activity of your limbs. So I just look past me, and even with the visual we have here, if you look past me, you see a portrait of the one. Who is responsible for us being here on today. So as always, we acknowledge that we do not own the rights to any of the music that we will be sharing in the video on this morning, but we thank God for those who have shared their gifts so that we might be able to share their music on this morning. Amen?
Amen.
So let's just praise the Lord on today, saints. victory this morning.
Oh, yes.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The scripture reading is going to come from Psalms number 61. Hear my cry, O God, attend to my prayer. For the end of the earth will I cry unto thee, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For thou hast been the shelter for me, and a stone tower for the enemy. I will abide in my tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covenant of thy wings. For thou, O God, hast heard my vow. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Thou prolonged the king's life and his years as many generations. He shall abide before God forever. O prepare mercy and truth which may preserve him. So will I sing praise unto thy name forever, that I may deliver, perform my vow. I read you Psalm 61 from the 1st to the 8th verse. May the Lord have a blessing to read, to hear, and to do another good work.
Amen.
Amen. Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
It's a blessing once again to be in the house of the Lord.
Oh, yes.
Thank God for this opportunity this morning that He afforded us to gather together to give praise and worship unto Him. For our Lord, He sits on the throne, and now we'll have a short prayer. Holy Lord, everything that we need, Father, is found in You, Father. For those of us, Father, who come here feeling broken, Father, there's restoration. For those of us who come here weak, Father, there's strength. For those of us who come here weeping, Father, there's joy, as we just heard in the song, Father. For those of us who have doubt, Father, You bring us faith, Father, the faith we need to continue on in the path You have set before us, Father. And as they were saying in the song, Father, about victory, Father, that we have come in with shame, Father, but You would bring us to the victory, Father, because You are our all in all, Father.
Oh, yeah.
And Father, those of us that are a heavy burden, Father, Father, You would give us rest, Father. And Father, we thank You for all of these things through Your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray, Father. Father, we say a special prayer upon our pastor as he bring us Your holy word, Father, that he will speak through You, Father, that his words may come, that Your words may come through him, Father.
Oh, yes.
And Father, for our First Lady, special prayer and blessing be upon her, Father, and every family representative in this church service, Father.
Yes, sir.
Either here live or online, Father, still a special blessing to our online viewers, Father, that they may come to know thee better, Father, and to all our ushers and everyone that participated in this service, Father. To our sick and shut-in, Father, our seniors, Father, our bereaved families, Father, the homeless, Father, the active military, our students, the essential workers, and our government officials, Father. Father, all these blessings we ask in Your Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
We just praise the Lord. Well, that theme of praise just keeps resounding and reverberating in my spirit today. We need to give Him praise. I know there's a lot going on in the world, but He's still worthy to be praised. I know you might be going through some dark times, but He's still worthy to be praised. You might not feel as good as you want to feel, but He's still worthy to be praised. It doesn't matter what blessing business, and whether we realize it or not,
oh, yes,
he's blessing us right now. I know we don't always feel like praising, but I remember something I heard in a song once. Somebody said there are two times you ought to praise God, when you feel like it and when you don't. So in other words, there's never a time that we shouldn't be giving God the praise. So again, we thank God for each and every one of you. We thank our deacons for the devotion. We thank our ushers and greeters on the door. We thank our deaconess, our trustees, our members, everybody who makes up this church family, our AD team, which is making sure that we can be seen and heard, not so that we can be seen and heard, but so that God can get the glory. Amen? Thank you to everyone who worked behind the scenes and in front of the scenes for the revival that was sponsored by our brother in ministry and our own Pastor Earl Williams Jr. of the Christian Missionary Baptist Church of Bunkerville, Louisiana. One revival in two locations. We started off the first night in Bunky and had a great time in the Lord there. And then we came here to Good Hope, and the good times continued. As we say in Louisiana, let the good times roll, or laissez le bon temps rouler. So we had a good time in the Lord. Amen. And we're thankful for the vision of Pastor Williams and the revivalist who spoke from their souls on this week so that we might be revived. And also on last week, we had two of our own receive an award from the Holland Lodge Masons. And those two are the Nelson twins. Brother Raymond and Brother Frederick Jr. received that Honesty and Integrity Award from the Holland Lodge Masons. So we are grateful to God for having young people who can be recognized for honesty and integrity. Amen. So I see one of the brothers here in the back. Come on. Let us see you. And of course, come on up with me, Father. Come on. Brother Fred Nelson Sr.
Amen.
Now they're not doing it to be seen.
All right.
But I just want everybody to know that we are really appreciative of the fact that God is blessing you to make an impact on your community. Following your father's footsteps, who also is making an impact in our community. And we're grateful to God for all of you, for all that you do.
Amen.
Amen. Would you like to say something? Okay. Well, to God be the glory.
Amen.
Thank you. Amen. And as I said earlier, some of you may be going through right now, but there's some good news. I want you to know that it's already getting better.
Oh, yes.
God is already working it out on your behalf. As a matter of fact, before you even went into the situation, God already had your deliverance plan.
Oh, yes.
So know that it's already worked out. Oh, and before we do that, I have the program right in front of me. Thank you, Sister Tony Dorn, for continuing to provide programs. And I have a tendency to get forgetful sometimes, even with the program in front of me. But we have a moment in time from Brother Stephen Maffitt, the son of Brother Michael Maffitt and our own Sister Margaret Maffitt. And these are his reflections. He says, "Truthfully, I have both my mother and father to thank for how I turned out in life. But who knows where I would be if my mother and father didn't have their own God-fearing parents to guide them. Then, if community-based churches like Good Hope weren't around, I never would have seen how much need there is for a helping hand. If I could sum up all of the teachings from my parents, grandparents, and Good Hope alike into one statement, it would be this: you were made excellent to serve others. And yet, though my career in education is dedicated to serving our youth, I believe my greatest achievement will be fatherhood of four kids who will be better than I ever was, because if they're anything like me, they will help more people than I ever could. Scripture reference, Mark 10:45, for even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. And again, that comes from our own brother Stephen Matthew. In our announcements, we will have choir rehearsal this Tuesday at 6 o'clock p.m. and our online live stream for Bible study Wednesday at 6:30. Again, choir rehearsal Tuesday at 6 o'clock and live streaming Bible study Wednesday at 6:30. And now for the ministry and song. God bless.
Put your hand on your neighbor's back and tell them it's already getting easier. When you practice out of your neighbor, tell them God's already moving on your behalf.
Oh, yeah.
we have any witnesses today that God did it? It might have seemed like it was all over, but God stepped in right on time.
And
one more announcement. Sister Aisha Bush will be teaching on this coming Friday morning in LaCount. I don't have the precise details at this moment, but Sister Margaret Maffitt will have that information. Again, that's this coming Friday morning in LaCount. Sister Aisha Bush will be teaching and ministering, so we thank God for the gift that he has given to her to share on that occasion. Hebrews chapter 11. Verse number 1. Hebrews 11. Verse number 1.
Oh, yes.
Familiar verse, one that most of us can quote from memory.
Oh, yes.
Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Yes. Oh, yes, sir. Yes.
And the evidence,
yes,
of things not seen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord as we speak from the subject this morning, right now faith. Right now faith. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The New International Version says, now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. The Amplified Bible says, now faith is the assurance, the title deed, the confirmation of things hoped for, things which are divinely guaranteed, and the evidence of things not seen, the conviction of their reality. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced by the physical senses. Last week, we examined the account of Thomas's refusal to believe that Jesus was alive until he had proof of the resurrection.
All right.
Except I see the print in his hand, except I thrust my hand in his side, I will not believe. But when Jesus appeared to Thomas, he said, because you have seen me, you have believed.
All right.
Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed.
Yes,
as a follow-up to that statement, we are going to begin a study on faith.
All right.
Right now. Faith. Faith that doesn't have to be seen to be known. Faith in which we have an assurance, even though we are yet hoping for our breakthrough, hoping for our deliverance, hoping for our blessing. But in order to fully grasp the meaning of Hebrews 11 and 1, we need to go back to Hebrews chapter 10. As the writer of Hebrews described, Jesus Christ's completed work of fulfilling the law through his sacrifice on the cross. He encouraged the readers to persevere in their faith. So for the sake of time, we will read from Hebrews chapter 10, verses 32 through 39. And the Hebrew writer penned these words: "Remember those earlier days after you had received the light, when you endured in a great conflict full of suffering."
All right.
Verse 33, "Sometimes you were publicly exposed to insult and persecution. And at other times you stood side by side with those who were so treated." Verse 34, "You suffered along with those in prison and joyfully accepted the confiscation of your property because you knew that you yourselves had better and lasting possessions." Verse 35, "So do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded."
All right.
"You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised." Yeah. Verse 37, "For in just a little while,
hold on,
he who is coming will come."
Oh, yes.
"And will not delay."
Yes,
Verse 38, "And but my righteous one will live by faith, and I take no pleasure in the one who shrinks back. But we do not belong to those who shrink back and are destroyed, but to those who have faith and or are saved." So now when we look at Hebrews 11:1, now faith.
All right.
After all you've been through, now faith.
Yes.
After all your suffering, now faith.
Yes.
After you've been talked about and ridiculed in public, yes, now faith is.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, yes. Now we can see now that the Hebrews were going through a difficult time, but the writer says now faith is. So the antidote for any anxiety that you might be going through right now as a result of your circumstances is right now faith. Let me say that again. The antidote,
all right,
for any anxiety,
yes,
that you may be going through as a result of your circumstances is to have a right now faith.
Yes, Lord. Oh, yes.
Hebrews says now, not tomorrow, now, not in the sweet by and by, now, even though you might be going through hell and high water, now, faith is, not eventually faith will be, but now. Anybody here have a right now faith in the midst of your storm? Now! Faith is present tense, not future. Present, not past. Now, faith is. What is faith? This is not intended to be a comprehensive definition of faith, but here the writer is introducing the concept that faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith is confidence in what we hope for. For the Christian, that does not mean wishful thinking. But we have a settled confidence not only in what we're hoping for, but we have a settled confidence in the one who is able to give us that which we hope for.
Oh, yes.
Many times we're so busy looking for a blessing that we neglect to look to the one who is supplying the blessing. Yes. Many times we're looking for resources, as my Pastor Bacon often says, but instead of being so focused on the resource, we need to be focused on the source. And when we focus on the source, who has already promised to supply all of our need according to his riches and glory, kind of reminds me of Wednesday night. He has already promised to supply all of our need, so we don't have to worry about our resources when we have our confidence in the source. We hope,
yes, Lord.
But we have confidence,
yes, Lord.
Even though we're still hoping. Yes. We believe it, even though it hasn't happened yet.
All right. Mm-hmm.
One commentator said, faith is the act of commitment on the part of the believer, whereas hope is the state of mind which he possesses. So what is it that gives us the ability to walk in faith? We possess the hope, but our hope doesn't mean that we just sit on our laurels waiting for something to happen, but we step out in faith believing that we can walk in victory even though it looks like the enemy has us defeated. We can walk in healing even though the doctor has said we're sick. We can walk in blessing, even though we might not know where our next meal is coming from. Why? Because our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. So we can act on it in faith.
Oh, yes.
Because we have confidence in God.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Not only is faith confidence in what we hope for, but it's assurance in that which we do not see. The evidence that Thomas was looking for, others had already received the evidence without having seen it. When I moved back from New Jersey, initially I didn't have a job. Still had bills. Still needed to eat. Thank God mom and dad were still around. But I couldn't just depend on them. So I was in the habit of sleeping until about 10, 11, 12. Some days not even getting out of the bed. But one day, something stirred in my spirit. I got up, got a nice, clean, white shirt and a tie. I wasn't going anywhere. I went over to my parents' house. And my mother looked at me and said, "Boy, you look like an executive today." I was anticipating.
All right.
That my season of unemployment was over. But I didn't wait. I had not even yet gone on an interview. I didn't wait until I got the job, but I started getting up at 8 o'clock in the morning. I started getting dressed like I was going to work. And before long, I had a job. What am I telling you? I didn't see the job, but I had evidence in my spirit that the job was coming, so I didn't wait until I had the job to start acting like I had the job, but I started acting like the job, and then God manifested the job. What am I trying to tell you? You don't have to see it to walk in it. You don't have to have it in your hand to believe it, but once God has placed it in your spirit, don't let anybody convince you that it's not going to come to pass. Some folk might look at you kind of crazy. Some folk might think that you've lost your mind. Some folk might think you don't know what you're talking about. but they might not be able to see it. But if God has given it to you, he did it for me. What God has for you, it is for you. Don't worry about who else sees it.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good word.
Faith will act like, make you act like. You got $1 million in the bank, and you don't have a dime in your pocket. Faith will make you act like you already been blessed because you know the one who's able to bless you. Faith will not let you wait until you get the blessing, but faith will allow you to go ahead and start giving God the praise in advance. You don't have to just praise him for what he's already done. You don't have to just praise him for what he's doing right now. But when the faith kicks in, you'll go ahead and get your shout on right now for what he's going to do. You'll walk like you received the promise, even though it hasn't yet manifested itself in the natural. Because you have faith in the one who stepped out on nothing and said, let there be, and the whole universe came into existence. If God had the power to turn nothing into something and make a whole world, then how many of you know that the same God who made the universe is able to bless you? How many of you know that the same God who made the universe is able to deliver you? How many of you know that the same God is able to heal your body, able to regulate your mind, able to mend your broken heart if you only have the faith? Faith will bring your future into focus even in spite of your present problems. So even though it might look dark right now, you can look way down the road and see that everything is going to be all right. And when you see that everything is going to be all right, you can walk around like everything is already all right. A few months ago, I pulled up KLB website, and there was something that made my heart glad. Whataburger is coming to Pineville. Even though the ground had not even been broken, I could already taste that Whataburger. And as I drove to work at Pinecrest, when they finally started putting the building up, before they even started with the orange and white paint, before the sign even went up, I was looking forward to a Whataburger. Because I believe, since the article said that Whataburger was coming, that by and by I was going to get a Whataburger. I texted my brother and my nephew because we had this little tradition that we had started. During the holidays, when everybody was here in town, we would make a trip down to Lafayette to get a Whataburger. But I wanted to let them know that we wouldn't have to go to Lafayette to get a Whataburger. So I'm excited about getting a Whataburger. And then finally the day came that Whataburger opened. And my excitement dwindled because the line was so long that the Pinecrest police had to come. Not the Pinecrest, the Pineville police had to come direct traffic. And now all of a sudden, this Whataburger that I had so greatly anticipated was now slowing me down from getting to and from work. But yet I was still believing that I was going to taste that Whataburger. But only after the line went down. So one night I finally made it to Whataburger. The line was short, but the wait was still long. But that was all right, because I was about to get my Whataburger. Got my Whataburger, finally. Got home, ate my Whataburger. Number one, the Whataburger didn't taste like I thought it would. So even though I had all this faith in Whataburger and all this anticipation with Whataburger, the next morning I had to call in because my stomach was tore up. From Whataburger. Although other people had told me how good their experience at Whataburger was, that wasn't my experience at Whataburger. What am I trying to tell you, my brothers and my sisters? Sometimes we put our faith in things. Sometimes we put our faith in people. But the things and the people will let us down. So although my faith in Whataburger led to disappointment, I just want you to know on today that faith in Jesus Christ will never let you down. Faith in Jesus Christ will change your song from he may not come when you want him, but he's right on time. And he'll give you the song that says Jesus is already here. When you know that you have faith in God, you'll know that you don't have to wait until the battle is over. But you can go ahead and shout right now. Faith in Jesus Christ will not turn seeing into believing.
All right.
But faith in Jesus Christ will turn believing into seeing.
Yes, yes.
Remember the disciples when Jesus told them, let us go over to the other side.
Yes,
when Jesus said, let's go over to the other side, that should have been enough. They should have known that they were going to make it to the other side.
Yes, Lord.
So when Jesus decided he would curl up and take a nap in the boat, on the way to the other side, a storm started to rage. And in the midst of the storm, the disciples went and woke Jesus up and said, carest thou not that we perish? But when you have faith, when you have the substance of things hoped for, when you have the evidence of things not seen, you know that if Jesus said you're going to the other side, it doesn't matter if the storm is raging. It doesn't matter if the wind is blowing. It doesn't matter if the waves are beating against the ship. If Jesus said you're going through, then you can rest assured you're going through. Faith says, I can see the other shore through the rain. Faith says, I can see the other shore through the storm. Right now, faith will say that even when the storms of life are raging, as long as I know I have Jesus in the boat, I'm going to make it to the other side. Faith in Jesus will take your tomorrow and translate it into today,
yes,
so you'll be able to live today like tomorrow has already come. Thank God for a right now. A right now thing. Faith. That is confidence. The substance of things that we are hoping for. And the evidence, the assurance of things not seen. If you're having a problem right now, you got to look past your problem. Look at the problem solved. You might be crying right now. Faith says weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Your morning might not hit at 12 o'clock midnight, but the morning is coming. And when you realize the morning is coming, then you don't have to wait until you see the light of day to act on it. It's morning.
Oh, yes. Yes, Lord.
Do you receive a right now faith today? Churches open. There may be someone who doesn't understand what we're talking about. We say right now, faith. The right now faith starts with believing what you can't see. You may not have been there when they drove the nails in Jesus' feet or in his hands. You may not have been there when they placed the crown of thorns on his head. You may not have been there when the soldier thrust the spear in his side. Blood and water came streaming down. But the word of God declares that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart, not simply that he died, but that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Notice he didn't say if you saw Jesus get up from the grave.
Huh. All right.
But Paul said if you believe in your heart that Jesus rose, then you shall be saved. The word of God tells us all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible also tells us that the wages of sin is death. So every one of us who sinned and came short of the glory of God are destined to receive the wages of death. But I'm so glad that the verse didn't end with the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. And that eternal life is through our resurrected Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So it doesn't matter how long you've been in church.
That's right. All right.
That's right.
Doesn't matter how many YouTube videos or Facebook live streams you watch. If you have not yet received Jesus Christ by faith, for it is by grace we are saved through faith. It is a gift from God. We're not saved by works, lest any man should boast. So I invite you on today, if you have not yet received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, receive him today so that you can have a right now faith. If you're looking for a church home and the Spirit of God is directing you here, I know we're not fully open. We still have COVID-19 going on, but right now faith. Right now, faith says that I can believe that COVID is taken care of. Because greater is he that is in me But if you're looking for a church home, not a perfect church, but a church that serves a perfect Savior, then we invite you to make Good Hope Baptist Church your home. You may have backslidden. You might have lost sight of the other shore. You might have grown weak in your faith. I invite you to be restored today, because God is willing and able to receive you. The only way that you can't make it is that you die without Jesus Christ. But as long as there's life in your body, there's a chance. that you will trust Jesus Christ as not just Savior.
Makes you seem so far away.
Sometimes we're eager to have Jesus as our Savior, but then once He saves us, we don't want Him to be our Lord. Receive Him as Savior and as Lord. As we stand all over the sanctuary, everybody who is able, how many of you are trusting Him on today?
Sometimes it's so hard.
Don't let your eyes deceive you. Sometimes your eyes will trick you. The enemy will try to make you think that God has failed you. It will make you think that you're still what you used to be and not what you're going to be. But right now, faith says, my past is behind me. Release it on today and walk in the victory that God has given you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for being someone who we can trust. For your word tells us in the 118th number of Psalms that we are not to trust man, but we are to trust in you and not to put our confidence in man. So even though people and circumstances may have let us down, Father, we are trusting you for the victory. We're trusting you for the healing. We're trusting you for the deliverance. Because, Father, we know that you are able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we might ask or think. So, Father, right now, in every situation, let us activate our faith that we might be able to walk in victory right now, even though it might seem like we're defeated, that we can walk in victory right now. Even though it might seem like our bodies are broken, we can walk in our healing right now. Even though our minds might be troubled, we can walk in the peace of God, which passeth all understanding right now.
Right now, Lord.
So move in every situation, Lord, as only you can move. And Father, even when we can't see it, we'll trust you. Even when it feels like we can't trace you, we will trust you.
Yes, Lord.
And as the songwriter said, we don't have to wait until the battle is over, but we can shout right now. So we give you the praise in advance for what you're going to do.
Yes.
And we count it as done.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
And the people of God said,
amen.
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 Trust Him on today. And now for our benediction. May our Lord Jesus Christ Himself and God our Father, who loved us and by His grace gave us eternal encouragement and good hope, encourage your hearts and strengthen you in every good deed and word. And as we leave this place, may we leave this place with a right now faith that assures us that leaving this place will not cause us to leave your presence. And we receive it all right now in Jesus' name. And the people of God said, amen. And may God bless you. Go in peace to serve the Lord.
It makes you seem so far away.
Back door. I'll catch you right here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.